Assalamu alaikum, dear students. How are you? Fine? Good. Today, you know, we are going to talk about a very important, you know, topic which is in 11th and 12th classes, both of you. That is paragraph writing. So, you must know that a paragraph is a basic building for writing. If you know how to write a paragraph, you will automatically know how to write an essay. For writing a letter, you need a paragraph. For writing report, you need a paragraph. Article, even for diary entry, for many pieces of composition, you know, you need a paragraph. Now, let us come to the point. What is a paragraph basically? I have written here. A paragraph is a piece of composition. You know, composition is a broader term. Under composition will come everything. Essay will come under it. You know, letter will come under it. Diary entry will come under it. Dialogue will come under it. Even if you write a poem, it can come under it. Whatever you write, there will be a piece of composition for you. So, it is a piece of composition which consists of several sentences. Relating to one topic. For example, if I ask you to write a paragraph on your own room in which you live, in which you sleep, you do not have to come out of that room at all. You have to write whatever is there in that room. You do not have to describe your house or theme or idea or thought. In other words, I can tell you that the position of a sentence is the same in a paragraph which the paragraph has in an essay writing. Because an essay is a piece of composition which is divided into different paragraphs, each paragraph having a single thought, single idea. In 11th class you have essay writing also. In 12th you do not have, but in 11th class you have essay writing. So, you must know essay, how to write an essay. So, in essay you have different paragraphs, in a paragraph you have different sentences. Here in paragraph also you have, you know, some sort of beginning and then middle and then end. Just like we have in an essay, we have a beginning, we have a middle and we have an end, we have a conclusion. Now, let us go further. First of all, we will look at kinds of paragraph, or for that matter this will come under essay also. It will help you in essay also. See, first is we call it expository. Now, expository paragraph, in this kind of paragraph, if you are supposed to write an expository paragraph or essay, you express your views. That is whatever you feel. You, in other words, outside. Okay? You see something. And then reflective is a type of paragraph in which you have to think, or you have to put yourself in that position. If I ask you to write a paragraph on if I were the principal of my school, so what would you do? So, you need to here reflect. And then narrative, it is a type of, you know, paragraph in which you tell a story, like the reader wants to know what happened next. It is a story type. And then descriptive, you describe. You describe some person, you describe some place, your village, your home, your mohalla, your city, your teacher, your father, mother, friend. So, it is called descriptive. And then persuasive. In a persuasive type of paragraph, what you do is that you try to convince the reader with your ideas. That is, the writer tries to convince, and he succeeds also to, you know, to make the reader agree with him or her. Then we have imaginative type of paragraph. What in an imaginative type of paragraph, you know, you imagine the situation. It's a dream like. For example, a visit to the moon. Okay, a visit to Mars. Then there is augmentative. Augmentative paragraph is a like expositive type of paragraph. But the difference is that in argumentative paragraph, what you do is that you take some side. That means you are in favor of something, and in while writing, you are opposing something. That is argumentative. You take sides. Then we can have a proverbial paragraph. Usually you get in 11th or in 12th class, you get this kind of paragraph, proverbial. That is, union is strength. For example, health is wealth. Rome was not built in a day. Knowledge is power. So you have proverbial type of paragraphs. And then you can have scientific, you know, paragraph. For example, write a paragraph on the mobile, on internet, on uses of computer, scientific topics, TV, radio. And then you can also have what's called as biographical type of paragraph, in which you describe some, you know, some personality, some leader. So you write his biographically, his life story. Okay, so these are the kinds of paragraphs, or we can say they will come under essay also. Okay, let us have a look at characteristics of a good paragraph. What are the characteristics, what are the attributes of a good paragraph? Number one is what's called as topic sentence. Topic sentence is also called the key sentence. It is the sentence with which you begin a paragraph. You see, topic sentence can come in the beginning, or it can also come at the end of a paragraph. I'll give an example. So let me give an example of topic sentence first in the beginning. Let you listen and let you then see the topic sentence the first. Only certain kinds of birds are well suited to woodland life. Most belong to the large group of perching birds. A perching bird has 3 forward pointing toes and 1 backward pointing toe on each foot. This toe arrangement helps both feet to grip a twig or branch. So perching birds are well designed to spend their lives among the trees and feed on the food there. So here in this type of paragraph, we have only certain kinds of birds are well suited to woodland life. Topic sentence coming in the beginning. Now have a look at the topic sentence coming in the end. Mark. At first, the earth's crust was made up of huge blocks of hard solid rocks. The outer layers of this rock slowly broke up into smaller and smaller pieces. Finally, stones, pebbles and grains of sand were formed. Many sorts of plants and animals lived and died on the surface of the earth. Their remains mixed up with the stones, pebbles and sand of the earth's crust to form soil. The outermost layer of the earth's crust is soil. So here he is talking about soil, the earth's outermost crust. So here the topic sentence comes in the end. Now, next thing that we should have in paragraph is supporting ideas. So supporting ideas means it must contain specific details, examples and facts to support the topic sentence. You can give examples. Then it must have unity. As I said, that it should relate to one topic, one theme, one idea, one thought. Okay, and then it should have variety. So by variety we mean that it refers to a range of vocabulary and sentence structures you use in your writing. You must use different. And then style. Style depends upon important considerations of audience for whom you are writing the paragraph and purpose. What is your purpose behind writing such a paragraph? And then clarity. First let us talk about coherence. Now coherence is the most important thing in a paragraph. It refers to the internal order of a paragraph. All sentences must be related to each other. There must be an internal order and harmony in a paragraph. All the sentences must relate to one topic or one theme, one idea. As I said, the theme should run through the sentences just like string runs through beads. वो जो माला होती है ना, उसमें जो जो अंदर से वो धागा होता है, ऐसे ही होना चाहिए. They must be related. In other words, coherence refers to the content of a paragraph. what you use. It actually refers to the meaning. The sentences must be meaningful. And then with coherence, another very important thing which we have in a paragraph is cohesion. So, for cohesion, it means connecting different sentences together with the help of cohesive devices, also called transitional devices. Cohesion refers to the organization. It refers to the organization. You can say how to organize things together. In other words, this refers to cohesion, refers to language in a paragraph. This is very important. This coherence and cohesion is very important. In order to achieve, you know, in order to achieve coherence in a paragraph, we use certain cohesive devices. For example, if you can write, I'll tell you, please write down. There are cohesive devices, there are words or phrases which help to, you know, one thing, one is they give your this organization to your paragraph, and next thing that they give meaning also to your paragraph. That is to express result, therefore, as a result, consequently, thus, hence. To give examples, you can write like this. For example, for instance, specially, as an illustration. To express comparison, similarly, likewise. To express contrast, but, yet, still, however, nevertheless, on the other hand. These are the words which will help you in writing a paragraph. To express addition, moreover, furthermore, also, to, besides, in addition. To indicate time, now, later, meanwhile, since then, after that, before that. To express sequence, first, second, third, then, next, finally. For, in order to make you understand, let me read a paragraph for you, and then I will tell you which of the transitional devices have been used here. Man has been able to spread across the earth so widely for four main reasons. First, he is a terrestrial animal, not restricted to the forest. Secondly, he can cross any natural barrier such as deserts, oceans and mountains. Moreover, he can live off a very wide variety of food. Most important of all, he has developed culture. He has learned to make clothes and build fires which allow him to live in climates where he would otherwise perish. To a large extent, he shares some of these advantages with the monkeys. They too can move over unforested land. They too can cross some natural barriers as they have the ability to swim. And they too can digest many kinds of food. Thus, a single species of baboon has spread across Africa from Dhaka in the west to Ethiopia in the east and south, all to the Cape of Good Hope. Similarly, macaques have done at least as well. One species, the rhesus macaques, is equally at home in forest, in open cultivated fields and inside heavily populated cities. Now, in this paragraph, we have transitional devices, also called cohesive devices. We have first, we have secondly, we have moreover, we have most important of all, we have to a large extent, we have two, used three times, and then we have thus, we have similarly. So, these transitional devices have, you know, made this paragraph into one whole. It looks one whole with the help of these. Otherwise, the sentence will be disjointed. They will not express ideas clearly. And then next we should have in a paragraph is clarity. We should have clarity in a paragraph. That is, everything expressed in a paragraph should be clear. Nothing should be ambiguous. We should not use those kind of words, bombastic words that the reader will not understand. Then brevity. Brevity, Shakespeare says that brevity is the soul of wit. So, brevity is very important in a paragraph. For example, tomorrow, if you are asked to write a paragraph in, say, 120 to 150 words, don't write more than that. You know, the upper limit of a paragraph is, it can be 300, almost 300 words, but at a higher level. Let us say at IAS, KS level. But here in your classes, you have to write paragraphs on 100 words, 150, 200 words. You don't go beyond that. And if you are asked to write a paragraph of 100 words, don't write only 50. So, this is very important. We call it, we also call that emphasis. How much scope you are giving to your, you know, paragraph, how many supporting ideas you are going to build bring in to write a paragraph. Now, before I give you some, you know, some home task, let me tell you that whenever you are writing a paragraph, for that matter, if you are writing any other piece of composition, let it be letter, essay, diary entry, whatever it is, article, you are writing, report writing, whatever you are writing, you should follow an acronym called CODA or POWA. Okay, I will tell you what is this. In CODA, you have C stands for collection of ideas. First of all, whenever you want to write a paragraph or you want to write something, first what you should do is that you collect your ideas in your mind. And the next, organization of ideas, that is you organize those ideas, which idea should come first, which idea should come after that. And then D stands for drafting, that is writing, write the draft. And then E stands for editing, that is correcting the errors of punctuation, grammar, vocabulary, and also, you know, spelling. So spelling mistake should not be there. Before you, especially you give it to somebody, or when you are writing an exam, there you don't have time to, you know, rewrite, but you can go for editing. And then R stands for rewriting, redrafting. Same is POWA, and another acronym. P stands for planning. First of all, when you want to write something, what you do is that you go for planning, you plan. And then you, next is that O stands for ordering of those ideas. And then W stands for writing. And then E stands for editing, as I said earlier also. So editing means when you are editing, you are trying to find the, you know, errors of grammar, spelling, punctuation, or vocabulary. What is that kind of, you know, vocabulary? For example, you have here, for example, word power, and one thing there is, that is we call that collocation. There is a word called collocation, collocation. I'll give an example. We say a beautiful girl, okay, but we say a handsome boy. We don't say handsome girl and we don't say beautiful boy. So we call that collocation. Which word is collocate with what? So that's also very important, because tomorrow actually somebody else is going to read your writing. That is, you should, that's what I said here when I told you that you must keep in mind, in style, you must keep in mind two things. One is you must keep in mind audience for whom you are writing, and then you must keep in mind purpose. What is your purpose of writing? So this is very important when you are writing. Okay, so this will help you in writing your paragraphs in a nice way. Now before I go further, I would like you to now give you some topics. Before that, let us also talk about something about cohesion again. For cohesion also you can also use grammatical and lexical linking devices. Grammatical and lexical, you know, lexical means which have to do something with the, you know, content words, noun, verb, adjective, adverb, short forms, contract short forms, negative short forms, come under this, and also demonstrative adjectives, this, that, these, those. Suppose you have repeated keyword here. For example, commuters do not use these particular train services very much. As a result, commuters tend to travel much earlier. So here you have used commuters again. It means repeated keyword. So you can do this. Then synonym. Next is synonym. For example, large cars and lorries are not advised to take this route. These vehicles should take the other route. sorry, other road. So when you have here large cars and lorries are not advised to take this route, these vehicles, so vehicle stands for what? Large cars and lorries should take the other route. Road stands for route. Pronouns and determiners, this, that, these, those, for example, my, his, her, your, when followed by nouns, they become determiners. For example, this book, that pen, that door, these boys, those girls, these vehicles, those people. For example, Napoleon was a great soldier. He was also a great administrator. So he stands for who? Napoleon. So this functions here as pronoun. He decided to take some heavy shoes with him. He thought that these would be useful in case he went walking. So that means here you are using he for pronoun, and here you are also using these as determiners, and then you are also using he again as a pronoun. Now let me give you some, you know, some topics, let you write, and just write 150 words on the topics, on these topics. Please write down. Number one, an incident that changed your life. You write about an incident which has changed you. Number two, a happy moment of your life. You have to write of your life. You don't have to see it in any book. A time when you did a right thing, when you were appreciated. If you were the principal of the school, as I said earlier, air travel has made the world a small place. You try an air travel. Smoking is injurious to health, not only injurious, dangerous. Happiness does not depend on a man's wealth. Educating women is essential. Forests are a backbone of our economy. Computers have brought enormous knowledge to our doorsteps. Mobile, advantages of internet. Social change is not possible unless people are educated. Road accidents can be prevented only by training the road users. Thank you very much. So I hope you have understood the whole philosophy behind this. So we have paragraph writing, what's a paragraph, and then I told you about different paragraphs, and then I told you characters of different paragraph, and whenever you are writing a paragraph, you must follow coder, and don't forget to follow coherence and cohesion in your paragraph, which are most important characteristics. Thank you very much. Stay blessed. God bless you. Thank you.
कोरोना वायरस जैसी वबा से बचने के लिए किसी से भी मुसाफा न करें। एक दूसरे से कम एक मीटर की दूरी बरकरार रखें। आंख, नाक और मुंह को न छुएं। खांसते और छींकते वक्त मुंह और नाक को ढांपे रखें। साबुन से बार बार हाथ धोएं और अल्कोहल वाले सैनिटाइजर का इस्तेमाल करें। तंबाकू चबाकर थूकने से बाज रहें। जिस भी सतह को छूना पड़े उसकी सफाई यकीनी बनाएं।